Okay, hello everyone. I am Tom Camp, part of the developer relations team at Ably, and today we're going to be looking into making use of AWS Aurora, which is an incredibly scalable backend solution which you can interact with using SQL, and how to make the most of it in real-time applications such as chat apps with WebSockets for communicating with end-user devices. Generally, the sort of architecture you'd be interested in using would be one where Aurora is kept away from actually ever interacting directly with your end users, as you'd expect, and using some form of kind of interface via an EC2 instance, let's say, which again is very scalable, can get as many instances as you need running and scale them up and down as needed. And those would then be the thing which are responsible for communicating via a real-time protocol such as WebSockets to your end user devices. The thing with this sort of architecture, however, is if you have the EC2 instances responsible for managing the WebSockets themselves, that's generally going to get problematic, as you need to then maintain like situations where WebSocket connections close or where users disconnect briefly, and also how to actually ensure that, let's say you have a very busy chat channel where it's the welcome channel and someone sends a message, that message is going to go to an EC2 instance. However, it then needs to be propagated to all other EC2 instances to then be sent to each of those instances' WebSockets, which is then another client who is subscribed to that channel, which then means that suddenly you're having to handle these kind of N squared problems of communication between all of your instances. They will need to be aware of which ones exist internally and also need to be maintaining all of these potential WebSockets, which add a lot of overhead. So as much as for, let's say, HTTP communication, you probably want to have a load balancer on the front end of this, which would be responsible for actually maintaining that direct communication with the end users and will appropriately allocate messages to different backend systems and keeps them separate conceptually. You would also want to do the same for real-time protocols such as WebSockets, where it is harder to do because you need to actually have maintained connections with these WebSockets being used to communicate with these end users. But it's still possible with brokers such as, let's say, Ably, where this is the kind of component which is responsible for actually maintaining these connections such that your instances on your backend are responsible only for maintaining a single connection, and that is to your broker of choice on that kind of middle plane. And then that allows you to have very specialized components for each of the different actions that you wish to be performed. So you have your end user devices, which are responsible for the actual rendering of information, as well as also allowing users to easily and understandably interact with the chat application, let's say, in this scenario. You have a broker, a PubSub broker, which is responsible for the actual WebSocket maintenance and ensuring that users maintain information, messages don't get lost, making sure that messages arrive in order, and all of the various things that one would expect from a modern real-time application. You then have your EC2 instances, which are responsible for the actual kind of potential transformations to data you might want, such as filtering or insertion of media, as well as then the final interactions with the backend service of Aurora, where the actual data is persisted and ready for querying in the future. Let's say if someone wants to search their chat history. So the question is, how do we build something like this? Well, actually, it can be very easy in this sort of scenario where you can, let's say, have a Node.js server running on your EC2 instance, where all we're going to be doing here is effectively treating it as a connection to Ably, where, let's say here, we have a real-time connection over WebSockets to Ably. And on that connection, we're going to be listening to a channel, which is messages from clients. And to that, we're going to be effectively doing a very simple transformation to represent, you know, just the premise of this, where we're going to be replacing all messages which contain a banned word with stars, just to, you know, filter it as a profanity, where in our case, the words potato and cheese are these banned words. Then we're also going to be creating this message in Aurora for potentially querying in the future or anything that would be needed to be done to that data post the real-time interaction. And that is literally it for the actual EC2 instance. We're then hosting a web page, which is what our clients are going to be using, which is just simply making use of the existing Ably chat component for creating a chat interface where people can send messages and receive messages. So if we just run that locally, we can quite easily see that we create our table, which is for our Aurora instance, and we have two chat pages here where effectively we're going to be sending a message. And that is going into one channel, going into our EC2 instance where it is being processed and made sure that it matches our banned words list and doesn't contain any of the words, persisted to our backend Aurora database, and then also repropagated to all potential other users. So if we look at the other chat, we can see that they have received the message and see it's from someone else. If this person then decided to try and say potato back, our instance is automatically filtering out and then sending it off to everyone else. And also that is what's persisted in the backend database. If you want to read more on this and actually get an in-depth tutorial on how to build something like this, you can find it on the Ably blog. Thanks a lot for listening. Have a great day.